Project Economy News now, and the cost of California's state parks. A new report says California has added more parks to its system than it can actually afford, and that the state should consider giving up control of some of them. Action News reporter Jacqueline Mazur is live in Monterey with a closer look at whether or not that could happen and what it actually means. Jacqueline?
Aaron, the report was released by the Little Hoover Commission and suggests Parks and Rec consider relinquishing one-third of parks that lack in statewide significance, but that suggestion isn't sitting well with everyone.
It seems that in making this kind of determination that the state of California isn't in touch with the powerful economic driver that outdoor recreation is, both for tourists coming in and for our residents in the state.
Supervisor Jane Parker tells us she's concerned for her constituents in Seaside Marina and Salinas. Parker tells Action News they have less park space per household than the national average, so even suggesting that the Parks Department give up one-third of state parks, perhaps affecting the Central Coast, becomes an immediate red flag.
From my experience, that undeveloped land usually ends up in the hands of developers, and then it can never be used for anything else. It's paved over, torn up, whatever.
The commission says Parks and Rec needs a new model to save the park system, a model built around shared management, innovation, and greater transparency. Add to that the expectation that the Parks Department generate more revenue from its operations. The commission cites Hearst Castle as one example, suggesting the tourist favorite might be better run by a group that has more experience protecting its European art collection, such as the Getty Museum. But for those who take advantage of the state parks regularly, the concern isn't so much about who's running them, but more so about keeping them open, period.
Just daily life, quality of life here in California, I think, revolves around the outdoors, and keeping those places accessible to as many people as we can is important.
Now, currently, there's no list citing which parks the state parks and rep should give up. We're told the plan at this point is focusing rather on how to keep the parks that they currently have open, open. Aaron.
All right, Jacqueline, thank you. State budgets $432 million for its state parks. That's less than one-half of 1% of the total budget. Meantime, you can find the commission's full 122-page report on our website, KSBW.com.